Hi, I'm Bailey Bass.
Hey, I'm Jamie Flatters.
And this is Rolling Stone's What Would You Do with the cast of Avatar: The Way of Water.
If you want to live here, you have to ride.
Let's do it.
Just breathe. Breathe.
Dear Bailey, for the past couple of months, I have been regularly swimming through a kelp forest off the coast of San Diego. Each time I swim there, I have come across this fascinating octopus. I feel as though I have become friends with the octopus. I can tell they understand me as I do them. My family has been wondering where I have been spending so much of my time, but I haven't told them because I fear they won't understand this friendship. What would you do? Sincerely, Misunderstood Swimmer 002? Aww. What? No, because I was kind of like, I don't know how I feel about this, but then it's like Misunderstood Swimmer. Like, this is probably like a lifelong friend, you know, that this
Firstly,
person will have.
Watch My Octopus Keeper. You'd feel less alone with your love plight. You should probably be open with your wife and kids about who your other lover is. They'd be more concerned if it was another human.
No, it's not a lover, it's a friend.
No, it's a lover. You were talking yesterday about the connection between cows and how they all need soulmates.
No, but cows
this
want
is a soulmate.
No, cows want soulmates with other cows.
And this person wants their soulmate to be an octopus.
No.
Don't say it's weird because this is this person's experience.
You
we're meant to
know,
be helping
them. You are right.
Them.
They are misunderstood. So maybe I misunderstand, even though I don't think I am.
So
what would we?
So what advice are you
what,
giving
no,
your love
what would we do is the real question. I would tell them. It's a vibe. I'd just tell them and go on with my life. You should be
tell
yourself.
Tell them it's a vibe.
No. I would tell them about it because it's a vibe. Like, you can be friends with whoever you want to be friends with.
That's our advice then. It's a vibe. Continue with the vibe. Dear Jamie, last summer I nearly drowned to death in the ocean. Jeez. Luckily, a dolphin nudged my body closer to the surface and saved me. From time to time, I come back to the pier and see dolphins jumping in the distance. I like to think of one of them that saved my life is there, and I smile and wave in gratitude. Today I learned that the city is planning on disposing chemical waste off the shore nearby where the dolphins like to swim. Now it's my turn to save my dolphin friend, but I don't know how. What do you do? Sincerely indebted and concerned.
What?
Wow, so you owe this person, because this dolphin, they saved your life, now you need to save theirs.
I would
how are
go,
we going to do this?
I would go to your local government and go to, what's that called? You guys don't have it here, do you? It's like the court where Judge Judy,
Yeah, we don't have the Supreme Court.
They're not going to listen to you.
A televised version of a court, like a fake court. This guy should go to a real court.
No. It's like
don't
a
go talk to Judge Judy.
Why?
It's all.
She
it's
could
all
give him great
it's
advice.
Not real.
You don't know that.
I think I know that.
This is your
you
British
Judge
perspective.
You think Judge Judy's actually sending people to prison?
Does she send people to prison?
No. I don't think so. I've never watched Judge
Exactly,
Judy.
You never
I'm
watched
so opinionated
it. That's
about
not what...
Sorry, but we're meant to be giving people advice.
I would go to my local government and have a conversation and, protest and speak out on social media and follow your heart. The animals deserve respect. Dear Bailey, my school is planning a deep sea exploration field trip, but my parents think it will be too dangerous. I love the ocean and learning about the creatures that inhabit it. They plan to bring us on a submarine and everything. How can I convince my parents that I need to go on this trip? What would you do? Sincerely, future marine biologist. Dang it, like these sincerelys really just make it like harder to say things.
Personal PowerPoint presentation?
What?
To your parents?
That's what you do? You would do?
Or like a vocalize your passion for marine exploration within song?
I think it depends on your age. In reality, if you're actually thinking of the school system, I don't think that they would do this because it is dangerous and it's a liability. So I'm sorry that I'm not thinking in a funny way, but a serious way.
No, we should take this seriously.
So, So I think, I'm sorry, I agree. Like, I would listen to, if my mom was telling me, like, it was really dangerous, but we'll do it when you're older, I would just understand. But the thing is, my mom would, like, do a substitute for that. It's like, okay, fine, I can't do this, so let's do something else. Like, oh, I was gonna say go to aquarium, but you have to do research because they're a little.
Is this for a school trip, right?
This is.
Just sign your own school trip thing.
That's what Jamie would do.
Yeah, just sign it yourself.
Dear Bailey, I enjoy visiting my city's aquarium on a weekly basis because being there brings me peace. I feel a deep sense of connection to all living things, and this location allows me to reflect on that feeling. So much so that I befriended the staff and have started sneaking into the tank to swim late at night. It's super illegal and probably dangerous, but I can't help myself. Should I stop? What would you do? Sincerely, Friend of the Sea 202. I make friends with all staff, so I think this is fine. I think it depends on your age, though.
Yeah, if you made friends with the staff, then you're good, right? Like, you're in.
Yeah, well, why? I mean, it's illegal. If they get caught, I don't think this person would get in trouble. The staff would, so.
Do you think they're, like, skinny dipping? Do you think they're doing it naked? Or do you think they've got their clothes on?
I think either way, enjoy your life.
Why did you find that sort of, like, promiscuous?
Because, like I've never done that, and I think it's, like, really, like, exciting to do that.
Would you do it in an aquarium, though? I just normally start off with, like, a pond or something, and then build
But what if there's a pond at the aquarium?
Imagine if there's, like, piranhas and you're skinny dipping.
But why would they do that? The staff wouldn't do that.
I am not suggesting that people at, like, SeaWorld go naked swimming with their...
I don't endorse SeaWorld.
Well, neither do I.
Oh, that's it. Continue on.
Fuck SeaWorld. Dear Jamie, my friend has a lot of pets. Every time I go to her house, I can't help but feel like the animals act differently around me.
Wait, I wasn't paying attention.
One of my friends is a very booky cat that I do not like, okay. So I know that feeling. I'm watching out for you, Mr. Mittens, I'll kill you. A few days ago, I realized that the reason behind this, I can talk to animals. When I first told my friend about it, she thought I was joking, but once she realized I was serious, it feels like she's creeped out. Now she invites me over a lot less. I feel like I can't stop seeing my friends since I'm the only one that can really talk to them. What would you do? Sincerely, Gifted Communicator 443.
So I can talk to chickens and dogs.
No, you, okay.
Yes, I can.
So how?
How would
you do that?
Okay, so I can make chicken sounds. I'm not gonna make them for you, but I can.
Well, you've got to.
Otherwise... I can't. I hear them and then I talk back to them because I worked on a garden, that was my summer job, and they had chickens and I would feed them and talk to them. And then my dog, you know that's how I can sing whistle notes now? Because I would talk to my dog and he like would, and I would start doing it with him.
What does that mean?
Whatever, I'm not, they know how I feel. They feel my emotions. But anyways, I get it, but I think you need to let go of that animal and continue on and find other animals that are not owned by those friends because I don't think they support you and you should find friends that support you. Dear Bailey, my dad is an actor and is working on a project where he has to wear blue paint all over his body, which is totally fine. The problem, he now says that he does not feel like himself without the blue paint on and has started wearing it everywhere. Aside from the humiliation this causes my family when we're out together, the blue paint is getting everywhere. This issue culminated at Thanksgiving when my grandmother said he would no longer be invited to her house. I'm hosting Christmas at my place this year and my dad has asked me if he can come as I'm the only family member that still speaks to him. And the film comes out on December 16th, so I think it could smooth things over with the family prior to our celebration. What would you do? Sincerely, loyal daughter 12. I didn't know you had a daughter.
Yeah, no, I jumped in with this one. Yeah, I'm sorry. I thought it would be good to email in and ask for your advice. What should I do? I just don't want to let it go, you know?
You don't want to let it go? You want to wear the blue paint forever?
Yeah, the method actors are who I desire to be. And
yeah, you just want to be a not be forever.
Yeah. So yeah, I got told about the Blue Man Group, like this group of musicians who always, and they're like, yes, but then I auditioned with the maracas and they were like, we don't need a maraca player.
I think you should just join the Blue Man Group, I think.
No, but they didn't want me in. They didn't want the maraca solo
happening. Then you should just go into the forest and live your best life.
Goodbye then.
Okay.